Good morning students. Today we are going to study the new lessons sources of energy. Okay, till now you have studied many forms of energy, what is energy, all these things you have studied. Also same thing you are going to study in this lesson, but little bit more. Okay, now what is energy? Energy in physics you have studied what it is. It is a ability of a body to do work. Oh, okay, or a capacity of a body to do the work, that is the energy. So what is energy actually? How much amount of work you can do is equal to the amount of energy possessed by a body. Okay, that is the energy. Okay, so this lesson is just for your understanding. Okay, and actually it is not for your exam, so we will just overlook this lesson. Now this was the energy. So now you are going to study the units of energy. There are different units of energies, as in SI unit it is different, CGS unit it is different, commercial unit it is different. Okay, so what is the SI unit of energy? The SI unit of energy is joule. So what is the CGS unit of energy? Yes, as it is erg, E-R-G. And the commercial unit which you have studied is the kilowatt hour. Okay, these are the units of energies. And most important thing you have studied, that law of conservation of energy. You know what is the law of conservation of energy? It is the law which states that, what it states that, that energy cannot be, it can neither be created or it not be destroyed. Means you cannot create the energy or you cannot destroy it. What you can do, you can just transfer from it from one form to the another form, just transformation it takes place. You have studied the example of a stone falling from the roof. Okay, if the stone is falling from the roof, it has potential energy. When it falls from, while falling, what happens? All the potential energy is going to convert into the kinetic energy. Okay, as you have studied the theorem also, as you have studied the topic, that what happens when the, in 9th standard you have studied, when the ball is falling from a height, so what happens at that time? The potential energy gets converted into kinetic energy. And if you will calculate the total energy for the different points, what happens? You can see that it is constant over all the conditions. All the points, if you will check it, if you will derive it, you can understand that it is constant overall. Okay, all points it is constant. So what happened? The total energy, that is potential energy plus kinetic energy, is always constant before and after transformation. Okay, so that was the law of conservation of energy. Now what are the sources of energy? Okay, so what are the major source from that we get different forms of energy? Okay, so the sources, so some conditions are there, some conditions should be there if you are using the sources. Means how the source means, if now the biggest source is the fuel, how the fuel should be, some conditions are there for the fuels. Okay, that you are going to study here. First you will study the sources of energy. What is the source of energy? It is a capability of producing or providing enough energies, enough useful energies at a steady rate over a long period of time. Means what it is? It is the source which provides more and more amount of energy for us for overall long period of time. For example, you can say sun over here. Sun, you know, from many years, millions of years, what it is doing? It is giving its energy towards the earth. We are using the solar energy. Okay, so how it is? It is also a source of energy which is providing us enough sources. And it is, how the energy is? It is a useful energy. It is providing us a useful energy. And as you know, it is providing us for a long period of time. So this is the source of energies. Now for this, some good, so now as we know, as we are using the source of energy, how the source of energy should be? It should be good enough so that we can use it. And what the good source of energy should be? How it should be good source of energy? It should be safe and convenient to use. If we are using this good sources, how should be? It should be safe and convenient. Okay, after that, how it should be? Easy transport, and it should be easy for transport also. For example, now you can see how the petrols are transporting. It is easy for transportation. Petrol, diesels, LPGs, these are easy for transport. Okay, and last point is easy to store. means what? It should be very easy, as we have seen how the this fuels are stored. It is stored in big tanks, okay, and it means storage should be also easy. So these are the source of energy, how the good source of energy should be. Now you are going to study about the characteristic of ideal fuel or good fuel, how the ideal fuel should be, okay, the fuel which you are using, how it should be good, what condition it should be for our use. See, it should have, what it should have? High calorific value, or it should have high heat value. This is the main condition for the good fuel. Then proper ignition temperature. Why it should have proper ignition temperature? Because it should burn quickly. If it will burn quickly, what happened means ignition temperature should burn quickly. High calorific value means what? Heat value. If it has high calorific value, what happens? It can means within less fuel it will burn more, okay. So here proper ignition temperature, it should burn quickly. If its ignition temperature is properly, not produce harmful gases after combustion. This is very important. If you are using any fuel and if it is giving out poisonous gas or harmful gases, what happens? It will affect everywhere. It will affect the surrounding. Okay, it will affect the nature. So whichever fuel we should use, what happened, the main or main condition is that it should not release harmful gases after combustion. The next is it should be cheap in cost and easily available. How it should be? It should be cheap in cost, so that everyone can means it should afford everyone. Okay, it should be cheap, and how cheap in cost, and it can be easily available everywhere. As you know, petrol, diesel, it is easily available everywhere, and everywhere means it is affording also. Every people can afford it. So easy and convenient to handle. How it should be? It should be very easy and convenient for handling purpose. Okay, so these are the conditions of the good fuels, and most important is it should burn smoothly and should not leave any residue after combustion. Okay, it should smoothly burn, and after combustion nothing should be left behind. This is the characteristics of a good fuel. Now we are going to study about the classification of sources of energy. Now how the source of energies are classified? They are classified into two types, that is renewable energy and non-renewable energy. Name itself can suggest it, what is the renewable energy and non-renewable energy. Now you can see here renewable energy. How it is renewable energy? Renewable energy means they are inexhaustible, means they will never exhaust. Okay, you will get the energy, means the name suggests renewable, means it can be renewed. Okay, even though you are using, you can use it and it can be renewed every time, and this can be used for a long period of time, it will never exhaust. Okay, so that is the renewable source of energy. Examples of renewable source of energy, main example is our sun. Okay, solar energy, then water energy, that is hydro energy, then wind energy, geothermal energy, biomass energy, many types of energies are there, okay, which are renewed every time. So advantage of this is what? First big advantage is it can be renewed, it will never deplete. But some energies are now in such a condition that they are being depleted. Okay, if we are wasting it, what happened? They are being depleted. So, and what are the again, what will be the advantages? That they don't cause any pollution. Okay, renewable energies advantages is that they will not cause any pollution. They are easily available, they are cheaply, they have no any cost, we can use it free of cost. Okay, these all are the advantages of renewable energies. Now the second type of source of energy is non-renewable energy. Now non-renewable means it cannot be renewed. Okay, so that it is exhaustible, it can be exhausted if you are using. So after using several large amount, you can, what happen, there is a condition that it can be exhausted. Okay, for example, coal, oil and natural gas. Okay, these are the examples. Then again, and as you know, these are commonly called as fossil fuels. Okay, coal, oil and natural gas are commonly called as fossil fuels. So these are the examples of non-renewable energy. Now what are the disadvantages? Okay, as they are non-renewable means disadvantages are that if you are using highly, what happened, it will be exhaust. Then what it is, there is a most important disadvantage is that it causes the pollution. Okay, they can cause pollution. These are the disadvantages of non-renewable. And as the renewable energy was free of cost, but now the non-renewable energy is not free of cost. Okay, so these are the classification of sources of energy. I hope you all have understood this. Still, if you have doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.